Hey guys, welcome to your general reading. What are your blocks and challenges for Sagittarius? This is going to be for your May 2022. You can apply this to any of your placements, even your nodes. So we're going to take a look and see what your current blocks and challenges are, and then we'll figure out how you could transcend and overcome these blocks and challenges. So apply this to your own unique situation, okay? Keep in mind that these are general messages. Take what resonates, leave the rest behind. If this message didn't resonate with you, take a look at your other placements. If you guys haven't done so yet, hit the subscription button and the notification bell so that you guys get notified on when my new videos post. Give this video a thumbs up, like this video, share this video, leave a comment down in the comment section below if this message resonates. Keep in mind that these are collective messages for the collective Sagittarius people, not tapping into one specific person's energies in particular. So if you're looking for a reading that's tailored to your own unique situations, to your energies, I suggest you book a private personal reading with me. Also, quick note that these messages, this reading is not really meant to be cross-watched. Roles are not really meant to be switched, flipped, or reversed. So this is more so a reading for Sagittarius's personal growth and spiritual growth, okay? So let's get started. What do we have for Sagittarius? What are Sagittarius's current blocks and challenges in finding? Not finding. What are Sagittarius' current blocks and challenges for May 2022? What are Sagittarius' current blocks and challenges for May 2022? What are Sagittarius' current blocks and challenges for May 2022? Sagittarius's current blocks and challenges. We have the Ace of Swords and the Ace of Pentacles. That's looking pretty good here. New beginnings here. Okay. Seems like you might be having some sort of breakthrough here. Maybe breakthrough regarding your career, your money here. Perhaps even breakthroughs about, you know, starting something new, you know, or that maybe you're buying a new home or something like that. Maybe you're buying a new car. But there's definitely something new here, or that you're having a breakthrough regarding your money, regarding your career here. Okay, you get the Five of Swords, and then we have the King of Swords. So Libra, Aquarius, Gemini energy. So right now, you're in this energy of putting yourself first, Sagittarius, okay? So I feel like you have a plan here. You have a plan here. A plan for yourself. So you're starting something new with that Ace of Pentacles here. Like I said, that could be anything. It could be a new business that you're trying to start here too. Okay, let's see what else we have here. Cool. That's too many, so I'm gonna do that again. We'll see if those come back out. What else do we have here for Sag? Okay, we have the Ace of Wands. That's three aces right there. I mean, Sagittarius, you could be in this energy of master manifesting here, okay? A lot of you guys also might be in this energy right now of sort of like pursuing your arts. A lot of you guys might be, you know, in this energy of maybe unblocking your heart space here and trying to go into things with an open heart, yeah? So we have the Knight of Cups here, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Seems like you're pursuing your passions here. Could be something in the arts here, okay? Some of you guys might be creators, artists, content creators, something along those lines, okay? Tell me about the Ace of Swords here. Why is this Ace of Swords here? Why is this Ace of Swords here? Tell me about this Ace of Swords. Okay, wow, we have the Tower here, Aries, Scorpio energy. And then we have the Fool here. There are new beginnings here for you. Seems like you're leaving these horrible experiences that you've experienced in the past, and I feel like you're leaving that behind, okay? So, you know, with this Tower energy and these Aces, so I feel like you might be accepting these major shifts or these major changes that are happening to you accepting them gracefully, okay? We have the Fool here. So that's more Aries energy right here. Aries energy could also be Aquarius energy. So you're starting all over again. You know, that Fool could represent movement. You could be moving or something like that. Perhaps even traveling, okay? Five of Swords here. We have the Magician. You're definitely manifesting, okay? You know, the Magician houses all the Aces. We're just missing one Ace, which is the Ace of Cups, yeah? So, King of Swords. So Gemini, Virgo energy, and we have the Five of Wands here. We have two fives here, by the way. You're experiencing a lot of change, or that you're going through a lot of conflict here. Maybe conflict with others, maybe conflict with yourself here. But if you are going through conflict with others here, I feel like you're leaving that behind because, you know, with that Five of Swords energies is about empty victories. You might not be getting anywhere with those individuals that you're arguing with here. Okay, give me one more. Tell me about this Five of Swords here. What is this Five of Swords here? Okay, we have the King of Pentacles. So Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. There's a lot of stability here regarding your money here. So there is career and financial success here for you right now. Things are going pretty well, I would say, for you. Sagittarius, Ace of Wands. We have the World. Look at that. We're closing out a cycle here, and then we're beginning a new cycle with the Fool card here. Okay? So there's a cycle ending here for you. Okay? The cycle perhaps really unexpectedly quickly closed out, especially with that Tower card being there. Knight of Cups. And then we have the Queen of Pentacles. So Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. We have a true pair right here. King of Pentacles and the Queen of Pentacles. So I don't know if there's someone here that you're trying to pursue here too. Could be new love. Okay. We do have that Knight of Cups here. Perhaps you're trying to pursue someone. Why is this Queen of Pentacles here? We have the Six of Pentacles. Whoever this is someone that you're really generous with, or that you feel like this person's really generous? It could be a situation that, you know, you have so much on your plate that you might not be able to pursue this person because you can't really equally balance this out, or this person that you're dealing with might be feeling this way. Okay, how can Sagittarius best overcome and transcend these challenges and blocks for May 2022? How can Sagittarius best overcome and transcend these challenges, blocks and challenges for May 2022? Oh, okay. Okay, we have the Six of Cups. Four of Cups. Seems like you're late. Could be a situation that you're really contemplating about the past here. Seems like a lot of you guys might be having nostalgia about the past. Now, that Six of Cups could be, you know, reminiscing about the old times with family members or friends or something like that. Could also be an ex here that you're missing here too, Sagittarius, okay? Let's see what else we have here. Okay, we have the Page of Cups and the Page of Wands. Aries, Leo, Sag, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, and the Ace of Cups here and the Ten of Cups. Wow. We have all four aces that are out, okay? So, you know, seems like it could be energy that, you know, you're closing the door on the past here, okay? You're no longer holding on to this because I feel like maybe the longer or that the more that you held on to it, it was causing you more trouble than good, okay? So I feel like you're letting all that go because, you know, moving towards the future here, there's a Ten of Cups here. There is emotional fulfillment for yourself. Perhaps, you know, maybe this Queen of Pentacles is like a past person, an ex that you're trying to get back to. It could be an indication that you're in love with this person, or that this could be new love here that's going to give you that emotional fulfillment that you're looking for here. Okay? Page of Cups and the Page of Wands. We'll pull more for them. Seems like you're starting over again. You're pursuing something passionately or pursuing something with an open heart here. You know, this could be anything. This could be your career or that this person that you're trying to pursue here. Like I said, it could be an ex situation or it could be new love. Just apply this to your own unique situation. Could be that you guys are meeting a new person that you have a past life soul tie here with. Okay, tell me about the Six of Cups. Why is the Six of Cups here? Okay, we have the Nine of Pentacles here. Virgo energy, pre-Empress energy. could be a situation that you're missing someone here. Okay. I do feel like it could be, you know, this feminine energy right here. Tell me about the Four of Cups and the Five of Pentacles here. Okay, there is loss here. So I feel like you might have, lost a person that you could have been dealing with here. Person could have walked away, okay, from you. Person could have ghosted you. Someone ghosted someone here. But I feel like you're leaving that behind, though, Sagittarius. I feel like you're no longer pursuing this anymore. It's sort of like could be a situation that you're learning from the past situation. If you messed up here, yeah. Tell me about the Page of Cups. Okay, we have the Seven of Wands. Page of Wands. Queen of Cups, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. There is someone here that you're still very passionate about, and I feel like there's an energy that you're hoping that in the future here that you guys could overcome whatever challenges that you've gone through here regarding a relationship, okay? Queen of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. Could be dealing with an Aries here. Lots of Aries energy here. You might even have Aries energy in your chart. Ace of Cups here and the Two of Pentacles. And then we have the Ten of Cups and the Death card here. Scorpio energy. You're definitely going through a major, major, major transformation here. And I feel like, you know, moving forward, there could be some sort of celebration that's happening. Interesting. We have the King to Queen of Cups. No, King to Queen of Wands here. Look at that. The King to Queen of Wands, King to Queen of Pentacles. Could be a situation that you want to reunite with someone, but I feel like you're no longer trying to force it or something like that. You're just letting it naturally happen. So let's say if you're trying to get back to someone here, I feel like there is an opportunity for you guys to reunite. Okay, so I feel like you could be someone here could be learning something here from a past situation, perhaps someone who's healing from it, learning from their mistakes or something like that, if they made a mistake. But it seems like there could be a union here. There could be commitment here between you and this person. But I do feel like you're definitely going through like a major transformation where you're manifesting in all areas of your life right now. And I feel like you're going through a lot of these changes here. Really good, healthy changes for yourself. Like I said, right now you're looking out for yourself. You're taking care of yourself right now. Okay, so this is looking pretty good, Sag. This is looking pretty good, I would say. If you're missing this person, I feel like I said, you're no longer, you know, trying to control the situation. You're just allowing things to be. Sort of like an energy of, okay, if this person comes back to me, great. If this person does not, great. Scorpio energy with that death card. What else do we have here for Sagittarius? We have the heart chakra. See, I feel like you guys are going into things with an open heart. You guys are opening your heart chakra up. If your heart chakra was blocked, yeah, memories of love. Seems like you're reminiscing about the past. Someone is reminiscing about the past. You're reminiscing about an ex or something like that. Okay? So let's see what else we have here for Sag. Seems like there could be a union here at some point. Okay, no need to worry. It seems like things will improve. Yeah, there will. So if you're looking for a reconciliation here with someone, there will be a reconciliation here because we have recovery. Okay? So right now, I just feel like you're in this energy of going about your daily life. Perhaps, like I said, you're focusing on yourself here. Yeah? Let's see what else we have here. And then a new romantic cycle begins. So it seems like there could be a reconciliation here, or that there could be new love in your life. Okay? I'm getting kind of both storylines for you guys. If you guys are leaving the past behind, you guys might be starting a new relationship, or that some of you guys might be trying to go back to an old person here. Okay? So Sagittarius, I hope this was helpful. I hope that this resonated. If it did, leave a comment down in the comment section below. Share this video, like this video if you haven't done so yet. Subscribe, hit the notification bell. I'll speak to you guys in the next one. All right, thanks guys. Bye.